I thought I'd goth out. You know, so I put on headgear. Goth by Otsuichi. I thought I'd show you the back because it's so much darker than the front. It's not goth at all. It's way too white. Goth, a novel of horror. Otsuichi. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. It's distributed here by Tokyo Pop. I bought it for $13, and they gave it for $13 even because it had some problems here and there. It'd been on the shelf a lot. I think that's just reshelving and reshelving from people picking it up and checking it out. Yeah, I picked it up because it said Goth on it. Plain and simple. And it was distributed by Tokyo Pop. I mean, what more could a girl want? I really like the use of experimental text. I'm a typography junkie, so I really like this cover a lot. Someone had taken apart her body in the forest. Her eyes, tongue, ears, thumbs, organs, each was nailed to a tree. One tree had, from top to bottom, the left big toe, the upper lip, the nose, and the stomach. Another had bits of her arranged like Christmas tree decorations. The murder was soon the talk of the nation. Psychologically twisted and emotionally wrenching, this compelling story takes Japan's horror tradition to a whole new level of fear. From a terrible scene of death or scenes describing looking at images of death to plain hangouts in the schoolyard or family meal times. Every single sentence is beautiful. It's written in a very poetic style. Yeah, it is quite terrible and quite gross. I love his style of gore. It's not that CSI close-up mind's eye type of gore, where you are writing from the perspective of a close-up camera angle. He's got a very wide-angle, laid-back way of describing gore and death, and just the beauty of death is wonderfully captured in all of his work. He seems to have a really close relationship with corpses and decay. The relationship between the two pro-antagonists, I don't know what they are in this book. The two main characters, the relationship between them is quite beautiful as well. Kind of a shut-in, warped girl, quiet goth type girl, and her equally warped yet not quite as shut-in or quiet friend, male friend. As an author, what Goth taught me and what this author continues to teach me is the power of quiet. There's a lot of scenes where it's the thoughts of the individual. There's not a lot of dialogue, and how you can keep a story moving with just that internal dialogue or things that they're noticing in their scenery. Instead of describing it from a third point of view, you get to describe it through the eyes of your narrator, describing the scenery, the plants, the sounds, the smells, the light. He does it very, very, very well. And that cover just... I really recommend watching the film, too, after the book, please. It's an atypical book. It's a typical book in that it's printed on paper and it has words inside of it. Yet, it is so striking and creates such a wonderful picture in the mind while you're reading it. I'd have to say it's atypical.